Welcome back to some Black Ops 4, and today we're gonna go over what maybe the old school COD guys recognize for me as my FAL gameplay. But this game is called the Auger DMR. It is a single fire, semi-auto weapon that absolutely murders. Get me lower in the water, please. I gotta be able to see down low. Let's go. One more. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Choke down.
Get low really quick. Break the line of sight. I'll go over the details of this weapon in a second, because it is a little different than what you might expect of the old FAL. They took a different approach in this game.
Recon threat down.
Woo! I stole that, and I don't feel bad about it at all.
Break him down.
So the old FAL is a two-shot weapon in most games, or even most, let's say, most single-fire. I say most single-shot weapons, semi-autos. And I say FAL because that's one of the most common ones used throughout the COD franchise, but there have been others. In this game, they made it a little different. The Auger DMR is a single-shot semi-auto like you'd expect. It has a higher fire rate than the FAL has in the past. I don't know why they chose to do that, but I think they did it because they made it a three-shot, which is the weird part of the Auger DMR, in my opinion. It is strange to see a single fire weapon chosen to be a three shot because typically it's just not good enough.
UAV above, commencing surveillance operations.
Oh my god, Automantle. I wish you weren't in the game.
Care package
available.
But this is an advantage in some ways. I'm dead. Oh, he got me with the auger as well. Got a sight on it. Oh, he doesn't. Never mind. There is an advantage to that, though. You might not. Did they have a sensor dart up? They might have. There is an advantage. Guys, you know, the bomb is planted. You know that? We're playing this game mode called Search and Destroy where you defend the bomb and, you know.
Bomb offline.
And, okay, we lose.
One tango left.
I'm not gonna say anything. I'm not gonna fucking say anything. You guys watching know what I'm gonna say, though!
Pay to fail. Get back in the game.
Having a higher fire rate and more bullets to kill would seem like a negative on a semi-auto weapon, because if it's a full auto, it hits for four or five shots, it's like, well, you could just hold down the trigger, and it's true. But a higher fire rate means you can make more mistakes, and you're still okay. I'm sorry if I sound a little weird, I'm still sick. But yeah, you can make more mistakes, and you can get away with it, because a higher fire rate is an advantage. Hellstorms are really good in this game.
Hostile down.
Back up.
Keep your mind down.
Destroy that really quick.
EKIA.
Type that fast.
One tango left. Take him out. Last man standing. You know what to do.
I can force him to plant, so it's okay. I had to play far back because of the care package. I really don't like care packages still because they just totally screw you on the rushes, but I feel like right now I'm not super... what's the word? I'm not extremely reliant on my ability to figure people out in this game because I just haven't played a whole lot yet. Whoa, my frame rate was bad there. I need to get a PS4 Pro as well. Very obvious this runs better on a PS4 Pro. There was a big comparison done. You put a sensor dart down over there.
Ballistic shield's ready to rock.
I don't think he planted it. Nope. Too reliant on your stupid sensor dart, dummy.
Built on victory.
Now, one thing I will say about this game, because armor's in it, FMJ is almost a necessary thing on a gun like this. So, you gotta run FMJ. I also run high caliber because there's not much else you can run. The operator mod is very good, but it's also kind of like not good. It's weird. And I'll explain that because it doesn't make much sense to those who probably haven't used it yet. The operator mod is called Double Tap, and it basically lets you fire two times, well, not two times faster, but faster. You can fire two shots when you pull the trigger once, but it doesn't necessarily fire two shots at the same time. So it gives you, let's say it's a little bit faster fire rate than like just single shot. But at the same time, it also has much more recoil. Like I just died to auto mantle. You got killed by auto mantle 100%. That has to suck. Dude, I'm adamant. Remove auto mantle from the game. It shouldn't be in the game. It's no, dude, no one has ever had issues just hitting X or A one extra time to jump. It was in COD for years. Nobody ever complained about it. Now you're making us auto mantle things if we just look at them like that guy and it gets you killed. Totally unnecessary. It hurts me a lot of the time as well. Like, that time it helped me, but it hurts me a lot.
Deploy care package on my beacon.
Let's use a UAV really quick. If we use a UAV early, normally I say don't, but it keeps people back. They won't rush as much. Right, well, I want to get aggressive. Let's go. What is this? Mantis. Okay.
Tackle. Deploy Mantis on my mark.
The bomb has been planted.
Oh, I got hit. He just murdered too. Nicely done. I need the Mantis to come out and clutch here.
Nine men going in.
Last man standing. You know what to do.
Profit kill.
Easy enough.
A bonus to whoever frags their last man.
Can this thing guard me? I don't think I got it in time. What is it shooting at? You suck! That's all good. I got the Hellstorm. Okay, that thing is like just more confusing than helpful. It's just shooting rockets into walls. I thought the guy was there. He walked past him. Thing sucks. Look at this guy though. Ripping it up. I forget the name of that gun. I liked it a lot in Blackout. I've been playing Blackout more. I still hate Blackout though. I'm sorry. If you like Blackout, it's cool. But until they like make that game's armor system better, you're not gonna see it much on my channel. Take a double really quick, you know.
Bomb.
Head glitch me? No, it's okay. Heal up. We're completely fine right now.
A bonus to whoever frags their last man.
Transitioning ballistic shield.
Where's he at? You would have died though, you know that.
We did what we were paid to do.
15 and 1. Not too shabby with the auger there. The auger! I don't have the operator mod unlocked yet, so I can't show you what that's like. I did have it in the beta. I think I made one video over in the beta, so if you'd like to see that, you can probably go find it. But semi-autos are still good, man. Don't sleep on them. I know a lot of people have been ripping, saying the ICR is sick. The freaking Maddox is sick. I love the Maddox, by the way. But the ICR especially is good against the armor. This gun does the exact same thing. When they have armor, you can just ruin the armor with this weapon. So if you have a lot of armored players, you're playing maps that have decent, you know, mid-range lines of sight. Even close range, it works. But mid-range, obviously, it excels. Like the remake of Slums, dude, it runs that shit. I swear. Thank you for watching, though. Hope you enjoyed. Until next time. And that's it for me. Bye-bye.